Santa hat. Yes, we have to wear the Santa hat. God, it's small. I think my head's been getting bigger. I'm getting smarter. Yes, I'm getting smarter. Yes, exactly. Hey guys, how's it going? Kriparian here. We've got our holiday YouTube video for you guys today. It's going to be a little bit different. We wanted to share a gift with you guys, and it is going to be the gift of music this year. A lot of you guys might not know, but I've been a pretty huge music guy for most of my life. It's just since I started streaming, and it's been like good 7 years doing that. I just haven't had any time to do any kind of this stuff on the side. I've missed out on it. But before that, my whole life, whenever I'd hear a song that would really impress me, I'd write it down. I'd listen to it. In some cases, I listened to it on repeat for days at a time. And man, I really do love my music. And today, hopefully I can share a few that you guys can perhaps reminisce in, or maybe, and likely even, there are some new titles that you can love as well. So here we go. We got top 10 holiday tracks from the Crypt. Well, not really, just kind of my favorite songs, but I try to vary it up a little bit. I do like a lot of different kinds of music, but it's generally metal. And as a result, number 10 on the list, Manowar, Warriors of the World United. This song is just so incredible. I heard it in like a gaming video compilation back way in the day. May have even been a Diablo 2 video. I don't even remember exactly. This song is power metal at its core. There's a lot of power metal bands I love, but there are none quite just like Manowar. And I think this song does them justice as a band. Number 9, ABBA. Man, I'm a huge ABBA fan. Quite contrast from the number 10 power metal clip. ABBA is a song that, ABBA's a band that really, really kind of relates to me in a way that no other, like, classic disco rock hybrid band does. The song I want to highlight is Knowing Me, Knowing You. I really love this song. Whenever I get like a new pair of headphones or something, I whip them on and listen to this song because I know every single sound, how it should work. And sometimes I get a really good pair of headphones, I tear up a little bit. It's true. Anya has seen me do that a few times. Number 8, Ian Gillan, Bluesy Blue Sea. So Ian Gillan is the lead singer for Deep Purple. Rania and I actually went out to see Deep Purple live, and they were breathtaking. Ian Gillan did some solo work, and in my opinion, Bluesy Blue Sea is the very best of it. It's really an incredible song. It'll take you by surprise how some of these masterpieces are still gone, fairly unknown to this day. You'd think with the internet, every great piece of work that has been out there has already been discovered. Some of these, and probably this one in particular, maybe there's another one on the list, will take you by surprise on how unknown they really are, and they really deserve to be a lot more popular. But, well, it is what it is. Number 7, Rush. Here Again. There's a lot of Rush songs I love. Rush is another one of those bands that has really kind of come close to me. Rush is a band that started up in Toronto, in the same area that I actually grew up in Toronto. So, you know, I learned that after I loved their music. So, you know, it's just kind of one of those things that makes you relate to the band that just kind of elevates it. Love Rush. And Here Again, I chose this song because it is the first song that I sent to Rania when we were first talking on the interwebs, before, you know, we met, before we got married, before we built this life together that you guys have seen. Rush is the first song I sent her that she really liked, so it deserves to be on our holiday list, damn it. Number 6, Queen, Flash. Flash is one of those songs that I love. I think Queen is one of the very few bands that has ever existed that basically has no bad songs. A lot of the bands that I like, you know, I like, you know, maybe a fifth of their songs. Some bands, they even have like one or two good songs, and that's about it. Queen is really just in a very select, very small group of bands that everything they make is just amazing. And I wanted to highlight Flash as it's, you know, a little bit of an unknown song, not quite that unknown, but relative to their other ones, relative to the recent success they have had through their amazing movie, by the way. The Bohemian Rhapsody movie has been just crazy good. It was my favorite movie until the Spider-Verse came out. We've had an amazing year of movies, by the way. Nonetheless, have a listen to that one. Fifth on the list, top five. This is, I think, the most underrated song on the internet. That's right. It is AC/DC Love Song. I couldn't actually find this song on YouTube. There's no official upload. There's nothing. In my opinion, this is the best song on the original release album High Voltage from 1975. It has Bon Scott, which was, you know, an incredible performer that no longer was with the band. And this, in my opinion, defines an era of AC/DC that a lot of people are not aware of, and a lot of people should quickly inform themselves of, because Love Song is just on another level. Have a listen and let me know. Number four, we're in death metal territory. Cradle of Filth, Hallowed Be Thy Name. This is originally an Iron Maiden song, an incredible Iron Maiden song, I should say. And Cradle of Filth does the cover justice by spinning it up with some death metal and hitting levels I've never heard before. I originally heard this song through a Dark Age of Camelot PvP highlight by a player called Gladrick. And it was just, I saw that video so many times, and it was, yeah, okay, the video was good too, but it was largely as this song that made it really so incredible. I love death metal when it has that melody to it, when it can be understood, and Hallowed Be Thy Name is still very near the top on any death metal song list I've ever heard, personally. Number three, bit of history behind this one. It's Parvati Khan. It's Disco Dancer. It's the Jimmy Jimmy Aja. That's right. You'd never thought you'd see this song on this list, did you? It certainly deserves it. It is a disco Bollywoodish song. It is a song I discovered around the time it was uploaded about 10 years ago on YouTube. And, you know, at that time, I'm like, wow, this song is amazing. I can't believe how good this is. You know, so I like bookmark the song. Every now and then I'd go back, listen to the track. And over the years, I've seen this song go from like unknown, like 2,000 views. And right now it has millions of views. Apparently this song is now famous across the world. And, you know, just seeing that and seeing YouTube grow at the same time, it's just been such a wonderful thing, such a wholesome thing for me to see that some of the awkward, weird things that I've, you know, found and really loved when I was younger are actually, you know, appreciated by the world at a large today. And there's nothing like Disco Dancer in my life that has grown quite that way. Number two on the list, World of Warcraft Invincible. This is the Lich King song. This is the Knights, not the Wrath of the Lich King, and Knights of the Frozen Throne. Too much Hearthstone lately for me, I suppose. World of Warcraft has breathtaking music. I was very close to adding some movie soundtracks on this list. For me, when I'm watching a really good movie, it needs to have that really good soundtrack. Like Conan the Barbarian is just, you know, the movie is carried by the soundtrack. A lot of the recent titles I can name, Thor is an amazing one. The Dark Knight, Batman, has amazing soundtrack. Tron has amazing soundtrack. There are a number of ones that just so good. And with games, it's even rarer, and it's generally been Blizzard games. I'm sure there's many reasons why I'm a Blizzard fanboy, but certainly one of the big ones is the breathtaking music they have in their games. Starting from Diablo 1, I think Diablo 2 was the absolute peak. I actually have Diablo 2's Wilderness as my intro song to every single stream I have ever done since the very very beginning. I just take these songs to heart. These are the games that I play, and they have some of the greatest soundtracks I've ever heard anywhere. It's part of the games. They deserve to be featured more than just, oh yeah, that's the song in the game. They really are masterpieces, and I chose World of Warcraft Invincible because I think it is the absolute very best Blizzard has ever produced. Invincible is really just on its own level, and the competition, let me tell you, is really tough. Diablo all the way through has had incredible music, and so has every single Warcraft title to date, especially World of Warcraft. So what can beat all that? What's number one on the holiday tracks list? It is Graveworm, Fear of the Dark. So Fear of the Dark is a song that highlights very different types of music. It is at a core a death metal song. Yes, it is once again a cover of an Iron Maiden legendary song, Fear of the Dark. I feel like Graveworm's elevation through death metal and other types of melodies that you can hear for yourself. Again, this song, I don't remember when I heard it first, but every time I hear it, it gives me, I don't know how to say it. It's not like a motivation, it's like a strength. You know, you kind of gain strength from listening to some of these. And wow, even just talking about it just feels so good. It feels so good to tell you guys about some of the stuff that I've loved so much over the years. So there it is, the very top of the list, Graveworm, Fear of the Dark. I feel there's someone that's, oh, okay. This wasn't planned. What? What?
Happy holidays?
Do you think my songs suck? Is that what it is? Oh, okay, good. Happy holidays,
Happy
guys.
Holidays.
If you guys want to listen to the songs, they're in the description below. And yes, much love from both of us. Love you. I didn't know you were sneaking up on me.
I didn't know that.
Okay.